22, 21, 22, and that was it, Camp Pendleton. The 4th Marine Division. We organized the 4th Marine Division in North Carolina. And then when they wake you up in the morning, say you are now a scout or you are a rifleman. You are a BAR man, you are a mortar man. Well, you saw the deep shot. We were trained at Onslow Beach in California for our landings. We had to make a landing for John Wayne and the Seabees, the fighting Seabees. They used our battalion for the fighting Seabees to make the landing for us. You don't see me in the movie. You just see them going ashore, that's all. And then we'd go back to our base. We were the first division to leave the United States and go directly into combat. Let me see, it's 2,325 miles from San Diego to the Marshall Islands. And we landed on Roy and the Moor, February the 2nd, I think it was. And we stayed there for 25 days. And I saw the big explosion, which was on Roy and the Moor. There's a picture of it there. They blew up a Japanese dump. And I love to see the Dauntless dive bombers come in, or the Grumman Wildcats, or the Grumman TBFs, which is the torpedo bombers. They would. I remember Carlson, of Carlson's Raiders. Our first landing was that we landed one day before the original landings on in Weetalk, and we took the island, and he set up all the machine guns facing Roy and the Moor. And then they seen all the Japs coming across. And he gave all the Marines hell. He says, you damn fools, don't you know what you see out there? He says, them are Japs. He says, they're coming over to kill you. I want to see every machine gun going or I'll give you a boot in the lake. Then I seen P-51s come in and they dive and strafe. And where they pull out at 2,000 feet, the Corsairs would come in and go down, believe it or not. Tree top, and we had them boxed in. Then after when at Weetalk, they took us home. Oh, in the Weetalk, and it was the atoll, and it was the stinkiest island I was ever on. You couldn't stand the smell. And they dug a big trench, and they had to take Japanese bodies, American bodies, and throw them in the same trench and bury them. The island was contaminated. We got dysentery from Anahuac and the smell because the flies were terrible. That's all. We transferred more. Then we went from there. We went to Iwo Jima. Right? The only thing I can remember on Iwo Jima is that some guy come over and says, "Don't take him. He's dead." He's dead. I said, "I'm not dead. Dig me up." That's all. The ash was very soft. You'd sink in the ash. Oh, you could see the shells coming at you. You could see little smoke vapors coming at you. And they'd land all around you. That's when I think they landed close and they bury you. The debris would bury you. And I think there was 7,500 killed that one morning on Iwo Jima. After that, it was just peaceful. No trees, no nothing to hide. Sometimes you'd see a cruiser come close to the mountain and stop about 50 yards out from the mile and fire right into the mountain. That mountain, that nobody knew, was all caves, underground. They go from one end of the island to the other. That's how they get around, but you never, there are very few on top. I never got a Purple Heart because I didn't think it was, I was hit with shrapnel on Saipan, but it wasn't enough to bother me. The sergeant said, "Did you get hit, Milley?" I said, "Yeah, here's a hot piece of steel, but we said, you go down to the beach and they'll press it." I said, "It ain't that bad." And that was it. So I didn't get no Purple Heart. If you report it, you'd get a Purple Heart. No, they send you back to a staging base and when you're back on your feet, you're back in service. Some of them never come back. They were wounded bad enough, they didn't. But if you were well enough to go back into service, you went back in. And I got up to the airport, and we stayed around there waiting. And I remember one day they says,
The island is secure. At 3 o'clock, they go put up a flag on Mount Suribachi. Everybody sit in silence and look north. We were in the southern tip looking at Mount Suribachi. The 5th Division was on Suribachi. That's all it was to it. I have 600 hours in combat.
That was it. We went back to Maui. Then we were getting all ready to go to Tokyo. We got everything packed, ships loaded to leave for Tokyo, and Truman dropped the bomb, and that was the end of the war. See, we lost 75% of the division. That was close to 34,000 men, and we lost 75%. And my company, we were 250 men, and I think there was only 10 men out of my platoon come back. See? I was one of the 10. I never seen any officers on the island because they all get hit. Yeah. Never seen an officer, they all get hit. Every one of them, the commander, the captain, and the lieutenant, company lieutenants, they all get hit.
All gave some, some gave all, some stood through for the red, white, and blue, and some had to fall. If you ever think of me, think of all your liberties and recall. Some gave all.